My children of grade 8, I welcome you all for the today's reading and writing class. Before getting into the session, let's see today's value. That is, reading is a gift. It's something you can do almost anytime and anywhere. It can be a tremendous way to learn, relax, and even escape. So children, reading is a gift. Try to read anything, anytime, and anywhere to learn something and to relax yourself even for escaping. So let's start today's reading session. So to improve your reading skill, let's read our textbook in our English classroom. So children, let's start today's reading session. Children, take your textbook Honeydew. Chapter 3, Prose. The title of the chapter is Glimpses of the Past. From page number 40 and 41. Children, let's start today's reading part from page number 40 from our Honeydew book. Chapter 3, Glimpses of the Past. So look at the passage here. Fifth point, oppression. Oppression means prolonged quarrel. Oppression means prolonged quarrel. Up, O-P, up, P-R-E-S, press, S-I-O-N, shun. Oppression in the year of 1765 to 1835. Look at the first word, sentence. B-U-T, but the British, B-R-I-T-I-S-H, British, continued. C-O-N-T-I-N-U-E-D, continued to oppress, O-P-P-R-E-S-S, oppress Indians. But the British continued to oppress Indians. Next line, see the next sentence. In 1818, they had passed Regulation 3. In the year of 1818, they had passed regulation, R-E-G-U, regulation, regulation 3. Next sentence. Under it, an Indian could be jailed without trial in a court. Under it, an Indian could be jailed, J-A-I-L-E-D, jailed without trial, T-R-I-A-L, trial, in a court, C-O-U-R-T, court. Let's read this sentence, children, completely. First block, keep your fingers and follow me, children. Repeat next to me. But the British continued to oppress Indians. In the year 1818, they had passed Regulation 3. Under it, an Indian could be jailed without trial in a court. So that's all from the first block, children. Let's move on to the second block here. Keep your fingers and follow me, children. Read along with me. Pronounce the words properly. All the time, British officers, O-F-F-I-C-E-R-S, officers, all the time British officers in India drew, D-R-E-W, drew big salaries, S-A-L-A-R-I-E-S, salaries, and also made fortunes, F-O-R, for T-U-N-E-S, tunes, fortunes, in private, P-R-I, pri, V-A-T-E, wait, private business, B-U-S-I-N-E-S-S, business. Let's read the sentence again, children, from the beginning. All the time, British officers in India drew big salaries, 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 and also made fortunes, F-O-R, for T-U-N-E-S, tunes, fortunes, in private, P-R-I, pri, V-A-T, private business. So children, that's all from the second block.
Let's move on to third block here. By 1829, Britain, Britain was exporting, export, ing, ing. Exporting British goods worth, worth 7 crore rupees, rupees, rupees in India. Let's read the line again, children. By 1829, Britain was exporting British goods worth 7 crore rupees to India. The British prospered, prospered, prospered. The British prospered on the company's loot while Indian industries began to die. So see here, keep your fingers and follow me, children. The British prospered on the company's, companys, company's loot, 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 while, while, while Indian, Indian, Indian industries, industries, industries began to, began to die, die, die. So let's repeat the line again, children. The British prospered on the company's loot while Indian industries began to die. So that's all from the fourth block, children. Let's move on to the fifth block here. Governor, G-O-V-E-R-N-O-R, N-O-R, Governor, Governor General, E-N-E-R-A-L, General, Governor General Bentinck, B-E-N, Ben, T-N, T-I-N-C-K, Bentinck, Governor General Bentinck reported, R-E-R-E-P-O-R-P-O-R-T-E-D-T-E-R, reported, back, B-A-C-K, back, H-O-M-E, home. Let's read the line again, children. Governor General Bentinck reported back home. Move on to the next line. See here, children, inside the cloud, the bones of cotton weavers. The bones, B-O-N-E-S, bones of cotton weavers. Weavers, W-E-A-V-E-R-S, weavers. Cotton weavers are B-L-E-A-C-H-I-N-G, bleaching the plains, P-L-A-I-N-S, plains of India. I'll repeat, children. Let's read and repeat again the same line. The bones of cotton weavers are bleaching the plains of India. So, children, that's all from page number 40. Let's move on to page number 41 now. Keep your fingers, children. This is the sixth point. D-I-S, this. S-A-S-I, T-I-S, this. F-A-C, fact. T-I-O-N, shun. Dissatisfaction. 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 In the year of 1835 to 56. Look at the first block, children. Education, E-D-U, education. Education in India was in Persian. P-E-R, per, S-I-A-N, Persian. Persian and Sanskrit, S-A-N-S, Sans, K-R-I-T, Crit, Sanskrit. Education in India, in India, was in Persian and Sanskrit. Next sentence. In 1835, English, E-N-G-L-I-S-H, English man named, N-A-M-E-D, named Maclay, M-A-C-A-U-L-A-Y, Macleay. Suggested, SUGGESTED. Suggested a change. I'll repeat the line, children. Read along with me. Education in India was in Persian and Sanskrit. In the year of 1835, an Englishman named Macleay, M-A-C-A-U-L-A-Y, Macleay suggested, S-U-G-S-U-G-E-S-T-E-D, suggested a change. Look at the next line. We should, W-E-V, should teach the natives. We should teach the natives, N-E-N-A-T-I-V-S, tips. Natives, T-H-R-O-U-G-H, through the English language, E-N-G, English, L-A-S-H, English, English language, L-A-N, language, language. Let's read the line again. We should teach the natives through the English language. I agree. Look at the next line, children. Agree. A-G-R-E-E. Agree. Let's read this block again, children. Education in India was in Persian and Sanskrit. In the year of 1835, an Englishman named Macleay suggested a change. We should teach the natives through the English language. I agree. Look at the next block here, the second block. E-N-G-L-I-S-H, English education, produced, P-R-O, produced, D-U-C-E-D, produced, clerks, C-L-E-R-K-S, clerks, to whom the British gave petty jobs, P-E-T-T-Y, petty jobs under them. Let's read the line again, children. Education, English education, produced clerks to whom the British gave petty jobs under them. Look at the next line. Incidentally, I-N-N-C-I-C-T-E-N-T-A-L-L-Y. Incidentally, it also produced a new generation. G-E-N-E-R-A-T-I-O-N, generation of intellectuals, I-N-N-T-E-L-T-L-E-C, T-U-A-L-S, twels, intellectuals. Let's read the line again, children. English education produced clerks to whom the British gave pretty jobs under them. Incidentally, it also produced a new generation of intellectuals. Look at the next line here. We must educate, E-D-U-C-A-T-E. We must educate our brothers, B-R-O-T-H-E-R-S, brothers. We must educate our brothers. Next cloud, and try to improve, I-M-P-R-O-V-E, improve. Try to improve their material condition, M-A-T-E-R-I, material, T-E-T-R-I-A-L, real, material condition, C-O-N, conditions, conditions. Let's read the line and try to improve their material conditions. Look at the next cloud. For that, we must convey, C-O-N, con, V-E-Y, way. Convey our grievance, G-R-I-E, grievance, V-A-N-C-E, grievance, to the British Parliament, Parliament, P-R, Parliament, Parliament. So let's read this line again. For that we must convey our grievance to the British Parliament. Let's read the blog completely, children, from English education, block number 2. English education produced clerks to whom the British gave petty jobs under them. Incidentally, it was also produced a new generation of intellectuals. We must educate our brothers and try to improve their material conditions. For that, we must convey our grievance to the British Parliament. Look at the next block here. By 1856, the British had conquered the whole of India. By 1856, the British had conquered, conquered, conquered the whole of India. whole, whole of India. Look at the next block. They cared little about the needs of Indians. They cared, C-A-R-E-D, cared little about the needs of Indians. Look at the next block. Next point. Our kings have become puppets. P-U-P-P-A-T-S, puppets. Puppets, and we have lost our old jobs. Let's repeat. They cared little about the needs of Indians. Our kings have become puppets and we have lost our old jobs. Look at the next sentence here. And lands. They are converting our brothers. They are converting our brothers. C-O-N-C-O-N-V-E-R-T-V-E-R-T-I-N-G-ing. Converting our brothers. B-R-O-B-R-O. T-R-T-H-E-R-S. Thirst. Brothers. The next one. You only talk. Do something to drive them out. D-R-I-V-E. Drive them out. Look at the last block again. Let's read from the beginning. They cared little about the needs of Indians. Our kings have become puppets and we have lost our old jobs and lands. They are converting our brothers. You only talk. Do something to drive them out. So that's all, children. We have completed page number. So today in reading session, we have completed page number 40 and 41. That's all from the reading part. Let's move on to the writing session now.
Children, that's all from the reading part. Let's move on to the writing part now.
Children, let's start today's writing part. 7, 12, 20. Letter D we are going to write. Then 8, 12, 20. Letter E we are going to write. Then 9, 12, 20. Letter F we are going to write from page number 30. So today in this session we are going to complete page number 30, children. So let's start. Write, sharp your pencil, write the date, draw lines. First write the dotted, then write the lines, children. Let's start today's writing, children. First let's write D, letter D. Write over the dotted line, children. Sharp your pencil and write. Then only you can write the dotted line properly. See, it should be over the dotted line only, children. So that's all. We have completed the dotted line. Let's write the next line here. Start from here. Write slowly, children.
So that's all, children. We have completed for 7, 12, 20 for today's session. Then remaining lines you have to write. Then let's move on to the next day, that is for Tuesday, 8, 12, 20. Let's write the letter E.
Try to write over the dotted line, children. Write slowly. So let's write the next line, children. Write slowly and neatly. So that's all from each letter E, children. Let's move on to Wednesdays, that is 9, 12, 20, letter F. Write over the dotted line, children. Write over the dotted lines. Sharp your pencil and write, children. So that's all. We have completed the dotted. Let's write the lines. Let's start letter F, children. So write neatly, children. So that's all, children. We have completed 7 today's handwriting, that is letter D, 7, 12, 20. Then for Tuesday, 8, 12, 20, letter E. Then for Wednesday, 9, 12, 20, letter F. So in this session, we have completed page number 30, children. So complete the handwriting. Children, let's conclude this reading and writing part with our today's value, that is, reading is a gift. It's something you can do almost any time and anywhere. It can be a tremendous way to learn, relax and even escape. So children, make use of this golden opportunity to improve your reading and writing skills.